pilots can typically anticipate severe turbulence. However, there is a phenomenon called clear air turbulence that experts say is almost impossible to detect. Nikki Schenfeld has more.
Experts say clear air turbulence can happen suddenly and without warning.
Clear air turbulence is much harder to figure out that it's coming. I mean, there's really advanced ground radars that can pick up changes in, you know, wind shear and that type of thing. But most airplanes really don't have much warning for that type of thing.
There was nothing, there was no warning. The next thing I'm thrown up into the ceiling where I've split open my head.
But to hit it over this spot of the Pacific Ocean isn't common.
In my recollection, this might be the first time we've had a report of severe turbulence in this area.
The National Weather Service warns aircrafts of any threatening weather. The Central Weather Service received the report from the pilot at 4:11 local time this morning. But right under those white lines, which shows where the pilot marked the turbulence, is a small cloud.
A little bit of a deeper look, you can tell that there's one small cloud that pops up just to the southeast of where the turbulence was reported by the pilot. So there's a potential that that small cloud may have caused the turbulence. The other scenario is that it's just clear air turbulence that's nearly impossible to detect.
And the cloud, called a tower cumulus cloud, reached the same height as the plane just before it dissipated. However, experts say planes are made to withstand turbulence.
The airplanes are so well built, we don't have problems with modern jetliners having problems in turbulence.
The National Weather Service also showed a plane which flew the same path just 3 hours before and reported no turbulence. Nikki Schenfeld, KHON 2 News.
And that's why they always tell us to keep that seat belt fastened during the flight. So how many people are injured by turbulence each year? Well, we checked on the numbers going back to 2013, when just 6 people were hurt, 2 passengers and 4 crew members. Those numbers jumped the next 3 years, climbing to 42 in 2016. And then dropping to 17 the following year. The rest of the passengers who were not treated had to wait in long lines to get their hotels booked and to receive meal vouchers. Some of the passengers say they waited at least 2 hours in the line, and once they got to the desk, it took another half hour to process each passenger.
I know we're all frustrated and we all want to get to our final destination, but it should be just a flat out no flights. We're not booking that. Here's the number. Here's your voucher for your food. Here's your voucher for hotel. Next. They had the flight manifest. They know we all need accommodations. Just start printing these things off. Like, I don't know why they need to speak to everybody individually.
Passengers said they were frustrated with the lack of communication.